your disclaimer from. I'm quite an IT nerd, as we would say, so if I dive too deeply into technical stuff, please just wave your hand. I know it can get very, very boring for people who, I don't know, might not want to get that much technical details, so please give me a note. I might not know this myself. But let's start. In the next about 10 to 15 minutes, maybe 20, let's see how many details I've got. I want to introduce you to the basic principles of HTTPS, why it's useful, and most of all, why you really, really, really should use it and start right now. If you have questions, there will be a Q&A session at the end, I believe. If there's something very weird for you on the slides, just also wave your hand and ask a question. So I hope I get very, very packed up view on this. But I will really try to take care of everyone and get you on the level that's also technical, but not too technical, and get you off some higher level details to sell it to your customers. Because that's what it's all about. Someone has to pay for the implementation or something else, and I want to give you the weapons and also the ammunition to get this running. First of all, HTTPS, what does it contain though? It is some kind of a validation stuff, an authentication stuff, and it consists of some levels. It's like there's some basic stuff, there's some advanced stuff, and I want to get you an idea of what's all about there. Because HTTPS, sadly, is not like HTTPS. There are differences. You should know about it. For starters, there are validation levels. So what does it mean with validation? What's validated? And that's exactly what it's all about. There is a domain validation. Let's add something up front. If you go outside and buy a certificate, buy something, buy SSL, then the first question you have to ask yourself is, what level of validation do I require? If you have to think about it, there is something at the end that's price. And the levels I will list up here, they are also increased price. The most top one is very cheap, and at the end there will be something really, really expensive. If you need something of it, you should know afterwards what you need. The first one is the domain validation. The only question it answers is the domain that it's going out for is the domain someone controls. You get an email, you click a link, and it's done. That's all the validation that will happen at the domain validation level. So that's where I got the lollipop there. On the second level, you see it's also a slice of cake there. It's getting neater. You've got organization validation. It's not just the domain you have to validate. So if you own the domain, that's nice, but that's not enough. You have to have some organization records, so some tax number, you have an address, you have a bank account. You have to prove that stuff. So if you have an organization validation level certificate, then you can also say, okay, that's not just a domain owner, but it's also a corporation or a company or an organization that's behind the domain. The last one, it's like a birthday cake. It's the nice and very neat green logo bar you know from the browser when you're visiting your bank's website, hopefully. If not, you should maybe switch your bank account, just to advise. And green is, because extended validation, if you want to get an extended validation certificate, it's a pain in the ass. Because it costs your time, it costs a lot of money, but at the end, you get a nice green address bar, you get a nice validated logo, and you get this nice certificate which says you own the domain, you own the company you tell them you own, and it really exists. So this is a sign of trust, and really is. The real use cases that come up are these ones. At the top level, you can see the most basic and the most important useful feature of SSL and HTTPS. It encrypts the data between the browser and the website. So saying this, on the left side you see those nice green check marks. It doesn't matter which kind of validation you use. It really doesn't matter. Each certificate is as good as the other one. It will make sure no one in between communication line between your browser, your smartphone, or whatever, and the web server you're talking to can tap into that connection and reach all the data. On the opposite side, if you do not use this encryption level and are surfing in the nice Wi-Fi hotspot right here, and you have an unencrypted site, someone will get into that connection, and that's easy by the way, can read all the data that's transmitted there because it's plain text. All your user data, your passwords, it's plain text. They will just be transmitted readable for everyone. Sounds scary, and yes, it is. At the lower part, there is the only use case to use something else than the domain validation certificate. It is if you need to know who you're talking to. So I made the example with a bank account. This is just one example. You can count up with many more, like your health insurance, or wherever you have very, very sensitive data stored. Then it is just not enough to encrypt the data on the connection, but you also need to know that the data, the person you're talking to, is the person you think you're talking to. And if I say person, I usually mean server or organization or whatever. No people behind there, I hope. The auth validation certificate, as you can see, is, from my opinion, there might be other ones saying different, it's quite useless right now. Because if you really want to make trust, you have to use the extended validation. The organization validation is too easy to fake and might add some level of trust, but honestly, if you need that trust, use extended validation. Everything else, domain validation, for just 0 to $10 will do the trick. Don't think too much about it. The next slide, I did the disclaimer before. It is a bit technical, so I try to rush through it. HTTPS is not as safe as it might be everywhere, because it depends on how you have implemented and how the servers are configured. There are some parameters, just you have heard them once. If you don't understand it and don't get it, it's not bad, just you've heard once. So it's a cipher suite. That's the way it's encrypted, so it's like the encryption algorithm. You might have heard of many that are broken in the last times. Those in bold, other encryption ciphers you can still use. And if you have someone who configures that for you, everything is good. In perfect way, your hoster already has done that for you, and you don't have to worry about it. If you have your own server implemented, if that is something you should take care of. The second one, the hash algorithms, that's something that the certificate provider, so the company where you're buying the certificates, has to take care of. Once before that, you also have to take care that the hash algorithm is the right one. Too technically, I understand. Last thing, server configuration, very, very important stuff. It's quite easy to configure, it's just a property in your Apache or Nginx or whatever you use. If you host yourself, you have to make sure that those legacy codes like SSL3 and TLS 1.0 are disabled. If the user is still used, they enable methods to circumvent SSL encryption, and it's useless again. The other stuff there involved, again, good stuff. Last thing, certificate provider. If you want to have a good laugh, search for Honest Ahmed and SSL. It's a very, very funny story about how the SSL system is broken in terms of it's just there to make money. It is. But on the other hand, it's very funny to read how to get back on that system. If you need this, VeriSign, Komodo, Mozilla, or there are many other providers who provide you with certificates, just take some reasonable, reliable provider to get certificates. We had also in the past years enough cases where the certificate provider, I believe they were a Dutch company or other companies, they were hacked, the certificates were broken, and they were useless again. So even worse, people could create certificates, and sadly it is happening again for some time. They can create certificates for google.com or other websites where you never would expect if there is a green HTTPS, you're not talking to Google. So make sure you take some responsible provider for your certificates. Now back to the business part. If you go out and think about HTTPS, the first thing you will get in mind is, oh, they have to pay money for that. The first thing your customer asks is, why should I pay money for that? My website will run even without it. The answer to this is, yes, it will run without it. And why should someone buy HTTPS when it's just that nice green bar in your browser? So, security. As I explained to you earlier, it encrypts the communication. If you use it to go to Starbucks or some public Wi-Fi hotspots, it doesn't matter where you are, and there are many people, airports or shopping malls, I don't care. It doesn't matter. Many people on one Wi-Fi network. It might also be at home. It doesn't matter. All the traffic runs through the same network, and everyone in this network can read it. They they can tap into it. It's called man in the middle. So it's technically not hard to achieve that situation if the network isn't properly secured. And most of the home or open public networks, they aren't secure for that. So security, if you want to log into your WordPress and your credentials are not spoiled publicly just by plain text with the username and passwords, HTTPS makes sure of that. Oh, that's my favorite one for selling to people. If people tend to say, oh, my website is so important for my business, HTTPS might get the tip on the Google ranking. Because it's nice, it's a very, very simple to implement and very nice addition to the Google ranking. They do that for some time now to upload those sites offering HTTPS connections. So why not use this as a selling point to customers? Most important for the whole stuff, I believe, is HTTPS is meant to give trust, to make people trust your website, to make people giving data to your website. Because you're talking on a business relationship. When you enter your private details into a website and you don't know where it flows, honestly, would you go to some website and enter your address, maybe your birthday, your email address, when it says, just enter all your personal details and your password here and you'll get something for free? I believe you even never would do that because it's crappy. On the other hand, taking a shop website, HTTPS is one of the factors that's adding trust. That's showing here is someone really taking care for your data, because your data is what matters. Your data, my data, that is what belongs to us, and giving that away is something that requires trust, in my opinion. Raising trust with HTTPS is something, technically spoken, something that we should do to honor those submission of data to our service. If you see it differently, you should reconsider, but honor those people who want to take care of their data. Same situation at the airport, sending all your personal data to a website that doesn't use HTTPS. Everyone can read it. You really want that? I wouldn't. The last point is a very, very recent point, and it's, in my opinion, making the whole SSL HTTPS story even stronger. HTTP 2.0, it is coming, it is arising. It is RFC by now, so it's standardized. The implementation in websites and web servers and browsers is going on. It is coming. And it will be the future of the internet as it makes all the points to a better level, which is the current protocol. Those of you who don't know what HTTP 2 is, HTTP, you have seen it in the browser, http://. This is the protocol which makes communication between the browser and the server, so it's some kind of a language. This language, sadly, is some years old now. It has several decades on it, and HTTP 2 is the way of making it better. Better in terms of it will be faster, it will be more modern by design, and it's an approach to get all the stuff out of the way that are making websites loading times go up, or I don't know. Many things, technically spoken, will get better, and HTTP is also part that many, it's got a lot of attention in WordPress right now. In the main blog, if you get interested in, there are discussions about what needs to be done to get WordPress on HTTP 2. To be honest, there's nothing that has to be done because it's just building up into the old HTTP, and it's breaking nothing, so it's backward compatible. But, and that's the main point here, HTTP 2 arose from Speedy. I don't know if many know that Google implemented Speedy as a protocol to make the web faster. They had a kind of experiment. You know, Google do that still. They make experiments and they throw it away. And it was a really great approach, but it was only meant to work with HTTPS. Now, HTTP 2 was standardized, and they said, no, we don't want to make it HTTPS only. That's just RFC, so that's just the standard. But right now, those major browser vendors we all know, and I was personally also shocked that also Microsoft did this approach, they say HTTP 2, yes, but only with SSL. So, I guess you get the point. Not having your website on HTTPS in the near future will cut you off on the next step of internet speed. And also web servers like Nginx, 80% of the internet right now, they also say HTTP2, yes, but no HTTP, not without SL. I guess you get the point here. Now what to do? Actually it's quite simple. If I haven't lost you already, now the very, very easy and quick steps how to get websites on SL. It is really easy. The first one, buy a HTTPS certificate. Rule of the buy, get a HTTPS certificate. You don't have to buy it anymore. I'll get to that later. The second point, this is you have to install it. So it's nothing WordPress. This is web server core. You have to have someone that is able to install it to your web server, or maybe you have a hosting provider who has a nice interface or a web panel, and you have a HTTPS button there or something like that. That is what you have to do first. You get a certificate for your domain name and get it running there. That sadly won't make WordPress work with HTTPS instantly, because WordPress is still HTTP by default, and that's something that's luckily very easily changeable right now. So all you have to do, open your WordPress, open the settings in WordPress, open the general tab, find those two fields saying WordPress address, site address, and all you need to do is add an S there. Sounds magically, but it isn't. Edit, and then press the save button, and you're nearly done. Not completely, but nearly. So you've done that, most of the way done. Now, the nice part of it. WordPress core is fully done with that. The bad part, only WordPress core. Existing content, blog posts, or whatever, you know, everything that's in the nice big text field, it won't be changed automatically because that's unstructured data. There is just a link containing HTTP and the URL to your site, maybe images or media content, and that cannot be changed automatically because there's no logical relation between the protocol change you just did to HTTPS and those content. But it doesn't matter, you can also change that. The other thing that you need to take care of on that way to HTTPS is plugins. Plugins, themes that use external contents. External content in this case means the includes of font awesome, or the jQuery library from the jQuery CDN, or Twitter API, or you name it. Everything that's not on your server. And also, things that are on your server. So if you write the theme yourself or your plugin, and you include resources, and there might be, I don't know, a reason why you don't use the include scripts, what you should do, by the way. Only include style sheets from WordPress, the functionality there. Then you might have added the HTTP because you just don't know another way. Last thing, ad networks. We work for some customers who use ad networks to deliver adwords on the websites. Sadly, and I honestly don't understand why, those networks are in some kind of prehistoric state and they don't offer HTTPS. I don't know why, it might be a code thing, but they don't have it. I repeat myself here, but I don't understand why. It doesn't make any sense. It's like, I don't know. I don't have anything comparable to that. So, make it better. How to make it better? Third thing, text, blog post. You can migrate it. It's not that hard. There are plugins in the repository that are called DB Search and Replace, for example. They move to your database, and they search for a string and replace it. So, that would be the approach to it. You can also, if you know how to, manually change that. I wouldn't recommend it if you don't know what you're doing, but those plugins are also working fine. Search for HTTP with your domain name and replace it with HTTPS. Done. The second part. If you have includes, so theme plugins, as I mentioned, there are two very easy solutions. If you have an external include, Twitter, Facebook, whatever, just use HTTPS with that. And if you use a plugin that includes something without HTTPS maximum, just use HTTPS or a native plugin offers to change it. All the big providers out there, Google, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, they all have HTTPS support. And it's not gonna hurt if you don't have an HTTPS site and include no HTTPS. But the other way around, if you have an HTTPS site and those contents are included insecure, then you get a yellow HTTPS because the content your website includes is not safe. Saying this in easy terms, if you have a website with HTTPS and you include those contents without HTTPS, you can forget the whole security stuff you have just built out. Why? Because there is one link in your security chain that's broken. That's broken because of that lousy missing asset you import. You don't want to do that. For the internal part, you have to be a little bit more careful. The easiest way would be just use the WordPress core functionality to import scripts and style sheets that are there. They will handle everything for you. If there is still a reason you don't do that, just remove the HTTP from the URL you're including, and those imports will automatically select HTTP or HTTPS dependent on the page you have opened and what protocol it is. It is that easy. Nothing get networks, if you want to and need to use it, and they don't have HTTPS, honestly, make them or leave them. Forget it. HTTPS should be more important than delivering ads on your website with a provider who doesn't really know why HTTPS should be important for external users. And honestly, there were enough examples where ad networks were hacked and used to deliver malware spams or such things. So it's the best solution to include code or anything else from someone external you don't trust. I don't trust ad networks. In conclusion, WordPress core has everything you need. We are there on the last meters because there are still some tickets about HTTPS in the bug tracker, but they will be fixed in, I don't think that it will be too long, because HTTP2 will be on focus. HTTP2 means HTTPS has to work, so we are on a good run here. All you have to do is get a certificate, install it, change the domain name in the settings, change the content. And if you're still thinking about why do I actually pay money for those certificates, you don't, and you shouldn't. Let's encrypt. For those of you who haven't heard of it yet, it will be the solution for all this neighing about money for HTTPS is too hard to install because it is a tool brought to you by Mozilla, by the Linux Foundation, and also automatic is part of this one to bring HTTPS everywhere. And what it does is, for one, it provides certificates for free. Free. Totally free. Lifetime. No 1 year and then you pay, it's free. And it will be on a level that will once a year automatically replace the certificate with a new one because that is how it works. What do you have to do there? It has to be implemented. So someone of your hosters, someone at the provider level, or someone who knows what it's doing, has to implement that on your service, and everything else should be run automatically. If you don't know that, they will launch soon. There might be a possibility to generate those certificates also on the website. I don't know if they really want to do that, but there might be a service for it. Anyway, remember, let's encrypt. And questions, I believe we are through in a minute, so yeah. I personally have really, really big and huge hopes in this one, because it will eliminate every discussion, every why should I pay, why isn't that for free, it will be. And I hope that we have, till the end of the year, a solution that HTTPS is possible for everyone without any limits. And if you're still considering moving to HTTPS, you might wait for this one, but nevertheless, for example, Start SSL offering free certificates right now. You can start with that, and it's not that much of a work to implement, but the benefits, they are great. And they are on a level everyone profits from. Yes, I am eager for that, so go for it, HTTPS right now. Thank you very much.
Questions for Jan?
I didn't quite get it. What about external links, backlinks, that still point to the HTTP?
Backlinks aren't any issue with this. It's about external includes. If your script needs JavaScript, for example, for Facebook, So the Facebook integration plugins, or if you require some Twitter integration code, okay. Then you put the code.
Coming back to my question, why is the if somebody links my web page with an HTTP, it will still link? Doesn't matter.
It has nothing to do with external links. It's just stuff in your website that pulls content from outside to your website.
So anybody linking to my website, for him it doesn't matter if it's within S or without.
Yeah, it doesn't
okay.
matter. Sorry if I got that wrong or was confusing.
So question here?
Yeah.
What would you recommend for migrating from a site that is running on HTTPS to HTTP, HTTP to HTTPS in terms of SEO?
Do it.
Yeah, but I have seen many cases where there was a slight drop in terms of traffic. So how would you recommend a smooth migration here?
Yes. Good point. Honestly, very good point, because you have to take care of several points. The easiest solution would be just offer your website HTTPS only. So you configure a redirect on server level. If a customer comes with HTTP, he'll be redirected to HTTPS. If you do that with a 301 redirect, Google will know. So if you have the breakdown, it will usually happen because Google maybe recognize your HTTPS domain as duplicated content. This can happen. You have to take care of that. But if you always use HTTPS and redirect all the traffic, that shouldn't be any issue for you, because there is no HTTP domain anymore. And with the 301 redirect, Google will also get notice of all the changed domains and update the index for you automatically. So clean solution, HTTPS only, and you're all good. I'm on the way there. Redirects are the one solution.
Great.
Okay.
Marco, now you put your hand up. It's the last question.
So you now say recommend like Let's Encrypt because it's free, but why would you still pay for NSL when Let's Encrypt is live?
You shouldn't.
No, but you also said that the extra validation that you should basically pay for it if you're like want to be trustworthy.
Yes,
so
yes. Good point. Let me move back to the beginning. It's always the beginning. That's where it all starts. The upper use case, encrypting the data. That's what Let's Encrypt will do for free to you. So as I said, org validation is a user certificate level. It's just a waste of money. Domain validation will be provided for free by Let's Encrypt. What they won't provide, because they cannot, you know, Let's Encrypt automatically, it's true, it's running. They cannot validate if you exist. They can just validate that the domain you create the certificate for is a domain you control, because they send an email to you. That's it. So you pay for the validation levels. And in my opinion, it's very fair to pay for that, because the companies behind that, they have to validate you are you, or you are at least the one you intends to be, the same you are. And in this way, this is what you still pay for, this is what Let's Encrypt will cover. This is what 99.99% of the people need for the websites, and this are the remaining special use cases where you need more. So that's a simple line. Okay? Okay.
Great.
Got it.